South Africa, and a very warm welcome to you. This is Afternoon Express. My name is Jeannie G, and of course, today we are still all celebrating our good health this side of the world. Now, today's show is all about love and marriage and a sweet carriage. And of course, we'll be crossing live to Pumeza, who is out in Cape Town to chat to lifestyle blogger Babalwa Ndalwana, who recently got engaged. Congratulations, Babalwa. And of course, we'll also be looking at some incredible wedding dress designs. And of course, Cape Town cover trio, the Black Ties, are here to serenade us. Oh, weddings always make me sad and give me a little frog in my throat. But first up, though, she is one of South Africa's most celebrated exports in the world of opera. Soprano singer Pumeza Matshikiza has graced the biggest stages around the world and is currently back home to perform with the Cape Town Philharmonic Orchestra at Coast and Bosch Gardens on the 22nd of March. That's going to be so beautiful. Take a look at this. Anything like me, that your body is covered in goosebumps right now from that sheer beauty, the quality of voice. Now connect with us online. If you've got any questions for Pumeza, please tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express, or go visit our Facebook page, or comment on a beautiful picture on our Instagram. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, thank you.
Let me just tell you, you are a doll. You are just such a vision to look at, and then even better to sound, to listen to.
Thank you.
Wow, what talent you have.
Thank you.
When was it that you were introduced to opera music? Because it's nothing that I can imagine that a child would, like, resonate with. Did it happen for you?
No, it didn't happen as a child. I mean, I grew up singing in choirs.
Yeah.
In South Africa, we have this amazing, amazing tradition of choral music.
Yeah.
And I discovered opera when I was about 14 or 15 years old on the radio, and I just fell in love with it. I think because also I was already singing in choirs, and so it was kind of an extra layer or an extra level of what we were doing in choirs, but I was so amazed, and I really wanted to be able to sing like that, because I could tell that there was a lot of work that went through being able to sing like that, so I was fascinated by it.
Your talent has taken you all over the world to perform on some of the most incredible stages. You opened up for the Commonwealth Games.
I did.
In front of 40,000 people. Were you discovered? Like, did somebody hear you and say, wow, we're taking this girl to the world? Or did you have an agent? Like, how did you break into opera?
Actually, I left for London to do my postgrad at the Royal College of Music in 2004. I was lucky to meet a composer called Kevin Volans, and I did some work with him, and he was very much interested in sponsoring me to go to the UK to do an audition.
Yeah.
And when I did the audition, he bought me the flight ticket. When I did the audition, I got a full scholarship, so I studied in London for 3 years, freelanced. So, and then I got a recording deal with Decca Classics, which is really one of the most reputable labels for classical music. So it started happening like that. There was one thing after another happening.
Yeah.
Scholarship, Royal Opera House, Young Artist Program, this Decca contract. So
incredible.
Just, yeah.
And how competitive is the industry? Like, is it really difficult to, like, scale up?
The industry is really competitive, especially sopranos.
Okay.
There are so many sopranos in the world. I don't know. There are just so many sopranos in the world. The tenors, the tenors have it much easier, because you could be not such a great tenor, but you could still, you know, have a career and make things work. But for sopranos, it is highly competitive.
You live in Berlin now.
I live in Berlin.
Berlin, for me, is such a sexy city. It's really, really great. What's life like there for you?
Oh, Berlin is amazing. Actually, for me, Berlin is nothing like the rest of Germany.
No, not at all.
It's like
it's
a country on its own.
Cape Town to South Africa is Berlin to Germany and New York to America.
Exactly.
It's their own place.
Exactly like that. Even my friends who are German, when they come to Berlin, they're like, oh, it doesn't feel like Germany at all.
Yeah,
it's amazing, very arty, you know, very free. I find that it doesn't have such a structured identity, although the main language is German, of course, but everyone is there and everything is, and people in Berlin are very much interested in seeing new things.
Yeah.
If you want to do a show where you just get naked and talk about whatever,
I've been to that club.
You will have people coming to just see that, you know, the craziest thing.
Yeah,
you
people, they're super open-minded.
They're so open-minded. They want to see what you are about, what's this art. They give everything a chance.
So do you, and what I find your life like? Do you gig a lot? Do you have, like, regular performances?
Well, I have, I'm a freelancer, so I'm not attached to one opera house. I do concerts, and I also do opera in different opera houses. When I've done lots of opera, I prefer concerts, because concerts, they take you around the world much lesser than... you have less time doing concerts than operas. When you do an opera, you stay maybe... For example, I did an opera where I was away for 5 months doing two operas, one opera and then another one. So I was like, no, now I want to do concerts. So sometimes I prefer concerts, and sometimes I miss doing recitals where you just sing classical songs with a piano, or concerts with an orchestra, or an opera with a full orchestra.
Amazing. Now, opera is often sung in Italian. Are you fluent in Italian now? Or?
My Italian is good enough, I would say. My German is better.
Really?
Yeah, I speak more German.
But now, those aren't your only talents, because I heard that you know what to do with these.
Oh, my God!
And it's not eating. Do you want to give us a little show?
No, I'm going to be too nervous.
No,
come
on. No, you can do it. Yeah, girl. You're
a genius. Come on. I was wondering what you were going to do with this apple.
You're so beautiful. I love you. You see, we're just celebrating women and their beauty and their talent all damn day. Thank you for doing that.
I needed six.
Can you juggle six?
No, it's a joke.
So now we've asked you if you've got any amazing questions for Pumeza. And Namon Dendlo asked, hashtag Afternoon Express, what are the challenges of being a soprano singer? Like in the industry, I suppose. What are the main challenges? Do you lose your voice a lot?
Yes, I do use my voice quite a lot. Yeah. You need time to rest, but also as you get older, your voice changes. So how you sang when you were 25, it gets heavier, you start to develop certain mannerisms, which you need to clean. You know, it's being an opera singer is more like being a sports person.
Yeah.
You train your voice, you try to keep healthy. I mean, I don't do any extra rituals, but I try to keep healthy.
You do boxing, though, that keeps you super healthy.
I did boxing for some time, and then I stopped. Now I have a new ritual. It's called the five Tibetans. They
are
amazing. The five Tibetan exercises, they're about five exercises.
Yeah.
And you do up to 21 repetitions. You start from three up to 21. And
it's like yoga Pilates based.
Yeah. It's something like that. And you can do it for 10, 15 minutes. Okay. You know, even when you're lazy, you can do it. And it's very old. They're quite old, about 2,500 years old.
I'm Googling that, the five Tibetans. Google
the five
it as well
Tibetans.
At home and let us know if you start. The five Tibetans.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. I'm going to try it. Our next question is from Shireen Abrahams. And she's asked, hi, Pumeza. At what age did you discover your love to be a soprano singer?
Well, I started singing when I was 5 years old, but it was not opera, of course.
Yeah.
I sang in church with my mother and my brother, and I also sang in school choirs.
Yeah, but the soprano came?
I was already singing kind of soprano, but child soprano, child soprano parts. I started training professionally when I was 21.
Okay, beautiful. You are just amazing. And of course, Pumeza will be back with us a little bit later in the show for an exclusive performance that you do not want to miss. Shucks, can't do that. After the break, though, we cross to Palesa, who is currently in the beachside town of Kumaki with lifestyle blogger Babalwa Ndwalana. I've got to remember how to say that. And of course, she recently got engaged, so we're going to be chatting to her after the break.
Clover Fresh Milk is the number one milk brand in SA. Made with love by Clover.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. I hope that you were having a lovely afternoon so far. Now, with the versatility of Clover Classic Fat Spread, any dish that you can think of can actually come to life. Speaking of life, with the speckworm challenge upon us of encouraging South Africans to plant at least 10 speckworm each in 2020, I think we can handle that. And of course, we want you to reward yourself as you do so. So Chef Chumi now shows us today that not only is it good for the earth, but you can also use it sparingly in cooking and, of course, baking applications, as with our butterfly speckworm cupcakes. So do join us in on the fun and, of course, the taste, and SMS the keyword Clover to 33650 to get the recipe. SMSs are R1.50 each, and free SMSs do not apply.
Hi.
Yum.
Yes.
What does the speckworm even look like?
It actually looks like this plant over
this
here.
This one.
Yes.
Beautiful. So pretty. I can plant these.
Do you want to give it a taste before we do anything?
Yes. Yeah, just what do they taste like?
Let me ask you to taste it first, and then I'll give you an idea of what I think it tastes like. It tastes like...
Oh. Ooh.
Yeah.
It tastes like something that's not quite ripe.
It tastes like a grape that's not ripe.
It tastes like a very tart Granny Smith apple. Yes.
Yes. So it tastes really good. So it's also quite great for us as well with all the nutrients it has. Just like Margie. So we're going to make sure we try and merge those two today.
Yeah.
All right. So what we're doing here is we're getting the base of our cupcakes done. We obviously want to end it off on a sweet note today in celebration of speckworm.
Yeah, I've love got a here, speckworm.
I think what you can do in the meantime is actually get started with the icing here. I've just put my vanilla essence in there. You can then just put in half of that icing sugar.
Okay.
Just half of it into your cream cheese. Okay. And then that vanilla essence as well. Perfect. And then you're going to just fold it in together with your spatula over there.
All of the vanilla essence.
All of the vanilla essence,
okay.
Yes.
And then
so basically what we're trying to do now, we're trying to showcase that as good as it is for the universe, for the world, for nature, for us, speckworm is also great tasting as well. So you can use it in many different applications.
Yeah.
And funny enough, the same with Margie Classic as well. You can use it to bake, you can use it to fry, you can use it to cook. That's my girl.
Yeah.
Elbow
now
grease.
What do I do with the rest of the frosting?
Just add more of the icing sugar.
As we go along. Oh, did you put half in just so that it's easier to mix?
Yes, it's easier to mix it together.
So.
Perfect.
And I'm not going to give me the kiddies jobs.
And then I'm just getting in our flour here for our cupcakes. And then we're going to spoon everything into our cupcake molds over here. When was the last time you had a cupcake? I think you're deserving of this right now.
No, I need a cupcake. I haven't had one in a very long time.
Yeah, because I know you've been dieting, so you do need something just to hold it.
Well, you
all
know
together.
That today I read this thing that if your immune system is a little bit low, or if you're feeling a little bit flat, chances are there could maybe be nothing wrong with you. Just your gut is maybe a little bit tired, and what causes that tiredness in your gut is often stress. So, eat whatever you want and not have as much stress.
True, I agree.
Who cares about the treadmill today? I mean, let's just get de-stressed having a little cupcake.
I also haven't been feeling well, but I do feel much better now. So I'm definitely having a couple of these after this. Just say. Don't look at me like that, Jeannie. I feel good. I'm good.
You know how stressful it is nowadays when someone says they're not feeling well in the same work environment as you?
I know. But I've done well to look after myself. So girls, back in action.
Okay, good. Yeah, well, you are looking beautifully glowy today. So
Thank you so much. You're not looking
ill.
Not looking like I'm good. How's
this
it going?
Happening? Yeah, it's done.
We were doing squats earlier. We were getting the lower body workout. Now we're getting the upper body.
I climbed Lion's Head this morning as well, actually. So, yeah. Like, now my top half is now well exercised.
Yes, I'm trying to make sure you get that summer body ready.
You are making sure that I'm earning these cupcakes.
Of course, you know it. Nothing comes easy these days. So, perfect. I'm just going to put these into our oven. Yeah. Baking them at 180 degrees for about 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Because we want them to be nice and golden on the top. We don't want them to be hard as rock. We're not making the Rock of Ages here. We're baking some nice, delicious cupcakes.
You know, I always
bake
cupcakes with my godsons.
Okay.
And I always overfill these things. But what's quite nice, though, and actually my godson, Jamie's only 3, bless his heart, but he told me it's quite nice because you can twist off the top like a little mushroom and it's like crispier. So he actually quite likes that.
So he does it on purpose.
Even my mistakes look good.
Only you, Jeannie. All right, so we're going to fill up. We've just put in our cupcakes. We've got some that we made earlier. Beautiful. And because we said butterfly cupcakes, what we're doing now is we're just cutting off the top of them. And then we're making some cute little wings.
Oh, my word, this is genius.
Yes. So
okay,
I'm going to do
one.
Okay, that's
what I can do with my burnt tops. I can butterfly them.
You can. Just make sure they don't serve people burnt cupcakes, Jeannie.
Well, no. When I say burnt, I meant a little bit crispier on the top.
Okay.
And then they're still chewy on the inside.
Because you have to represent
whoever
you are.
I've learned a thing or two. I don't know. I've got you to impress now.
Perfect. Get the wings going. And then we're also going to garnish with our speckbomb as well.
Okay, what do? Cut this in half now.
Cut that in half, perfect.
I can't believe how you got them to look like butterflies. You are the best. Oh, wait.
Thank you very much.
Oh, wait, these are all done.
I'll try.
Okay.
All right, and I think this is probably the one part that you're going to enjoy more than me.
Yeah, I did quite like doing that, actually.
Let's let you get busy with
but
that.
But I don't know if mine will come out looking as cute. Now, look at this. You're going to have to look quite closely to get what we're doing. You just take the two halves of the tip and butterfly that
yes,
went well. Let me just
right.
see what you've done.
You've got it
back there.
Perfectly.
How cute is that?
And then we're going to use our speckbomb as
baby.
Well, I almost said antennas. My data
buttons. Oh, wait, there you go. Yes, it's the antennas.
Antennas, and there we go.
Oh, hear me, that is so sweet.
Perfect for
these
you.
These are the best cupcakes ever. I mean, how lovely is that? Let us know what you think. And SMS the keyword Clover to 33650. If you need to see this one more time, here's a quick recap. You've got to make these. Oh, I love them, Jimmy.
Thank you.
Fresh Milk is the number one milk brand in SA. Made with love by Clover.
So L-O-V-E, love is in the air. And while we tuck into those delicious cupcakes, Palesa is out in Komiki today to catch up with influencer and lifestyle blogger Babalwa Ndlwalana.
Thank you so much, Jeannie. Good afternoon, South Africa. I'm coming to you live from the Last Word Hotel, all the way in Long Beach, Komiki, where it is, as you can tell behind me, an absolutely beautiful day. And what's even more beautiful, of course, is celebrations. So next to me, we have recently engaged, mother of two, lifestyle blogger, influencer, Babalwa, a woman of many talents, quite clearly. Girl, congratulations. Please may you spill the tea.
Thank
tell
you.
Me
Thank
all
you
about
so much.
It. Tell me all about it. I'm so jealous.
Well, Zola, my fiance, he proposed on the 19th of October, which is a day before my birthday. He actually had this whole setup. We had a picnic set out at a beautiful forest in Durbanville, and he proposed right there. He got a photographer to capture the moment, obviously, and I knew nothing about it. Like, I was just a week after I had given birth to our second born, Ngosi, and a few days later, he proposed. So all my family knew about the whole thing, and I did not know anything. So it was quite a special moment, I must say.
I mean, I do love a good surprise, and it sounds like Zola knew exactly how to make you smile, which I'm all about.
Yeah.
And other people that make you smile are your two little ones. Now, South Africa, I just have to say, this lady is a Wonder Woman. You found out you were pregnant with your second born when your first born was only 6 months old. I mean, how are you even alive right now?
I am literally hanging by the thread. No, I'm joking. It's really not that deep. I feel like people make it really difficult, but it's not that much. Like, with the great support system that I have, it's not that difficult managing a household and managing two little babies.
Aww.
So it's so much fun. Like, we really do enjoy being parents, and being a mom is something that I've always wanted to be. So it's honestly, like, the best thing that could have ever happened to
me. Yeah, and it looks so good on you. You are glowing from the inside out. I can just see the happiness exuding out of you. But something else that exudes exudes out of you is your drive, your ambition, your hustle. You are a full-on hustler, and I just, you know, I take my hat off to you. Do you believe right now where you are in life, whether it's career and family, is this it? Or have you, can you
definitely
say, Mama,
not.
I've made it?
Definitely not. So, funny thing is, I feel like it's really only the beginning, because growing up, I always wanted to be on television, and when I actually was on a TV show that played on SABC3 when I was 16. Mm. So as I approached my final year in high school, my parents really said that I need to find something, like I need to study and get a qualification.
Yeah.
So I did my research and found a degree that would be intertwined with the industry, which is advertising. So I did a BA in marketing communications at the AAA School of Advertising. And I feel like I'm on the road into being the woman that I've always aspired to be, with using my platform, such as my Instagram, growing my following all the time. I'm on to that journey, and also being in the advertising industry. So I'm definitely not there, but I must say I'm on the right path to becoming that person.
That is so key. It's very, very crucial. I mean, I always say that you might know your destination, but you don't know the paths and the lanes that life might take you. You just have to be willing to go for the journey, and your journey has been beautiful. I think that you have done everything with such grace, with such poise, and with an incredible amount of strength. Mm. So when you look at yourself right now and the path in your career that you've come, what's the most exciting moment that stands out for you, or in life in general?
I think the most exciting thing about this whole journey is the fact that people have received me quite well, which is something that I really wasn't planning on doing. Like, people call me an influencer, a mom blogger, content creator, and it's really nothing that I planned. So all the content that I create is very organic, it's very natural, and most of the content I put out there, it's really just me journaling my life on a day-to-day basis. And it's quite nice and quite surprising and exciting that people are really receiving it so well. It's really heartwarming.
And I think people connect with how genuine you are. They connect with your authenticity, and people love. I mean, we
That's true.
To see something in someone else that resonates within us. So you resonating with South Africa, and we are listening, we are paying attention, but we have so much more to come up with you a little bit later on in the show. We're getting our nails done, we're having a full on pampering session here. As you can see, we're having such an incredible time at the Last Word Hotel here in Long Beach, Komeki, where of course AfriDerm is taking care of our every skincare need. Over to you, Jeannie.
You're beautiful. Love the shade of your skin. An all-in-one solution for beautiful skin.
Yay, so congratulations again to Babalwa on your engagement. And later on in the show, actually, we've just got the thing for you in our Fashion Express segment as we take a look at bridal wear by designer Janita Toerien. So definitely you can choose her wedding dress from this incredible lineup of the most beautiful wedding dresses. But coming up after the break, actually, we're getting really classy with Cape Town singing trio, The Black Ties.
Next time on Tropical Island of Treasure Curaçao, after some dramatic twists in the first week of team challenges, it's time for the first elimination.
What?
Now we get to see who will double cross who.
What was the strategy?
We're not a threat.
Betrayal always comes from those closest to you.
How do you play this game with an honest heart?
Catch Tropical Island of Treasure Curaçao Tuesdays at 7:30 p.m. Repeat Saturdays at 8 p.m. only on SABC3.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, before the break, we caught up with lifestyle blogger Babalwa, who recently got engaged to the love of her life. Now, when it comes to the big wedding day, our next guests know all too well how to get the party going. Now, the Black Ties are one of Cape Town's most renowned cover trios. Chad Simon, Loy Jansen, and Kino Lee have performed at any type of function that you can imagine and always managed to bring a sense of class and charisma to the gig. But Babalwa, if you're watching, now's your time to book them to play at your wedding because they're really, really busy. Hi, guys.
Hey.
You all.
I remember the first time that I saw you guys perform was in Durban.
Yes. Yeah.
Very many years ago, yeah. And I lost my voice.
Yeah.
And the three of you came to the rescue like real pros. Remember, you gave me everything from whiskey to soda. You guys carry everything in your pockets.
Yeah.
And we're like giving, like, a thank you for that.
It's a pleasure.
But that's why you've got such beautiful voices.
We threw it together.
Yeah, you really do. And you're swooning couples all over the country. What do you love most about playing at weddings?
I think it's just the energy that you get back from those people. The people are happy to be there because it's a joyous occasion. Yeah. So to take part of that and be able to exchange that kind of energy, I mean, who doesn't want that kind of
thing? How good is it to always be surrounded with love?
That's
that
amazing.
Is your job.
Yeah,
so, so cool.
Is it contagious?
I think so. I think so.
Contagious
yeah,
for him?
It's been a bit more contagious
for him.
He's engaged, was contagious?
Yeah, it's contagious. Okay. No, it's super
good
contagious.
Good to know you love is contagious. Well, let's beat Corona with love.
Yes.
So what is the most requested wedding song?
Well, I think it changes all the time, but I mean, there's always, if we're doing a more romantic set, there's always an Ed Sheeran song.
Yeah.
If we're doing, I mean, generally we do party sets. We come in to bring the party to your people. That's what we do.
Strangely enough, internationally, the trend is for most requested wedding song, You're My Best Friend by Queen.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
That's the most requested wedding song.
Oh, well, I would like to marry my best friend.
Aww.
Yeah.
Aww.
That's a good start.
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Oh!
And, I mean, do weddings ever go wrong?
Yeah.
We haven't experienced anything like horrendous.
Yeah.
But we've heard.
Yeah, we have
heard, yeah.
And also by the time I think we get on stage, people are there to have lots of fun.
Exactly.
You know, they're a lot more settled, the pictures are done. You know, we come in like kind of before the DJ starts playing, so we kind of take them on this journey.
And none of you have ever been hit on by the bride?
No.
By the bridal party.
The bridal party.
Gets a bit raucous.
Wow.
Yeah, no.
Scary, actually.
Yeah.
Everyone loves a bridesmaid.
That's a crack.
Okay, so you're going to perform for us today. What's the song?
So it's a medley of a song called You and I and Lost in Japan.
Oh, beautiful. Take it away, Black Ties.
Mwah. Enjoy.
Mwah.
You fix your makeup just so. Guess you don't know that you're beautiful. Try on every dress that you own. You were fine in my eyes a half hour ago. If your mirror won't make it any clearer, I'd be the one to let you know. In the world.
is one flight. We've been in the same time zone. I'm looking at your timeline. I'm seeing all the rainbows. I got an idea now. I know it sounds crazy. I just got one question. All I gotta ask.
You got plans tonight? I'm a couple hundred miles from Japan tonight. I was thinking I could fly to your hotel tonight. Cause I can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. I can't seem to get you off my mind. Let's get lost tonight. Let's get lost tonight. Baby, you and I can't seem to get you off my mind. Let's get lost tonight. Let's get lost tonight. Baby, you and I can't seem to get you off my mind. Oh, oh, oh. I can feel the friendship. You can cut it with a knife. It's more than friendship. I can tell you're thinking about it. Do I gotta convince you that we shouldn't fall asleep? It'll be a couple hours and I'm about to leave.
You got plans tonight? I'm a couple hundred miles from Japan tonight. And I was thinking I could fly to your hotel tonight. Cause I can get you off my mind. You off my mind. I can't seem to get you off my mind. Let's get lost tonight. Let's get lost tonight. Baby, you and I can't seem to get you off my mind. Let's get lost tonight. Let's get lost tonight. Baby, you and I can't seem to get you off my mind.
Get you off my mind. Okay, I can't sing. But anyway, I think we've definitely found the perfect performers for Babalwa's wedding. Now let's head back to Komaki, where Paleso is actually chatting all things health, wellness, and beauty.
Living my life like it's golden, living my life. Oh, I'm so sorry, Jeannie. Ah, as you can tell, I'm just taken by the music. I feel so inspired. And how can I not be? Have you checked out my view? We are sitting in the most incredible destination here at the Last Hotel, the Last Word Hotel, all the way in Long Beach, Komaki. The rooms are so spacious and so beautiful, giving me the most incredible sense of serenity, truly feeling at peace here. And there's no better way to usher in a full-on girls' day, a full-on girls' treatment here with Jade. And of course, we're back with our influencer, mommy blogger, and newly fiancéed. She put a ring on it. Babalwa. I mean, ladies, how incredible is the view? And how are you finding the vibe here at Last Word?
I'm finding it completely amazing. We're having a blast today, and you girls are great, and you look stunning. Yeah. And now your nails look stunning too.
I mean, and we have you to thank for that. Our nails really do look so cute. I had my nails done earlier, and have you checked out this bling? I mean, when you're good at your job, you're good at your job.
Thank you.
As someone who is so talented as a nail tech, it's bride season, people are getting married and whatnot. So why is it so important for a woman to get her nails done on her big day?
Well, I don't think it's just important on your big day. I think it should be done at least monthly. It just makes you feel more put together and more complete. But on your big day, then this beautiful hands of yours is going to represent one of your most iconic photos. It's going to be the two hands together, joined in love.
That's true. Oh, I'm taken, South Africa. I am a gone girl. You can only imagine. Jade, though, what trends are we seeing in the bridal community? What is in? Is it something that is a go-to staple classic that every bride needs to go for?
Well, some brides are climbing out of the boxes these days, so we're actually seeing a lot of nude with black nail art, a lot of darker undertones for colors, which is pretty strange, and then obviously the nude, the all wonderful nude, but add a bit of bling and I would vote for nude.
Beautiful. And besides getting your nails done, what other treatments should brides be looking at getting? Or if you're just a woman trying to spoil yourself and trying to look cute, what other treatments should we be going for?
Well, I personally, on my big day, would definitely want to have a massage to get rid of all that stress. Mm. Go for a steam to detoxify. Definitely a facial to make sure your face is perfect. Perfect canvas for your makeup artist. I would do hair treatments beforehand so my hair is nice and soft and manageable on the day.
Yeah. Those are some good tips. I'm definitely writing that down because one day is one day, South Africa. Do not count me out. Mamalo, are you taking tips as
well? I definitely am taking tips.
What are you looking forward to the most in terms of all things self-care on your big day?
So with me, it's all about taking care of your skin. Mm. Like, your skin has to look beautiful on the day and you have to be well-rested. So I definitely agree with Jade. Going for a massage and making sure, going for a steam as well, making sure that your skin is looking radiant on the day. Mm. And just taking care of yourself. Make sure that you take care of your
Another thing
skin
that all the ladies always forget is toes. They forget that their feet are in photos when they take pictures of their garters. All of them forget.
That's
I always
one.
Have to remind them.
That's a good one. Ladies, it has been such an incredible afternoon spent with you. Lastly, Babalo, skincare routine, your regime, how does it look like and how do you ensure radiance, shine, and just pure health is coming out of your pores?
So what I usually do is that I mask my face twice a week and ensure that I drink lots of water and get enough sleep. Mm. I also exercise. If I'm not in the mood to really run, I take walks along the beach. And just make sure that you tone, you scrub, exfoliate once or twice a week as well. Just to make sure that your skin is very, like, even toned and it's not ashy or flaky.
Beautiful. So, I love that. And talking about beach walks, we're just going to take two steps out of our balcony here and go enjoy this incredible beach all the way at the Last Word Hotel in Long Beach, Gomeki. Ladies, I hope you're ready to exercise with me after the show because we are about to have such a good time.
Thank you so much,
Jade, for getting our nails
done.
We really appreciate
gorgeous.
It. And for you, Babalo, all the best. I hope
Thank
you'll be
you
inviting
so
Afternoon
much.
Express on
I
your big day.
Will. I definitely will. Thank you.
You're beautiful. Love the shade of your skin. An all-in-one solution for beautiful skin.
So we've met the perfect wedding band, but what about the most important part of any wedding? The dress. After the break, we look at some incredible bridal wear by designer Janita Toerien. Express
yourself. Find your smooth fortune with Tropica. Buy a Tropica, follow the entry details on the pack and stand a chance to win your share of 1 million rand in prizes, such as a trip for two with KLM to Amsterdam, LG G8X cell phones, LG TVs and dishwashers, guest vouchers, guest watches and accessories, plus the smooth grand prize of a Suzuki Ignis. The more Tropica you buy, the more chances you have to win. Tropica, nothing smoother.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express, and I have to say the day is about to get so much prettier. It's time for another edition of Fashion Express Thursdays, and of course the theme of love and marriage we're definitely carrying through, and we thought it really fitting to invite someone who specializes in bridal wear. Now, Janita Toerien has been making dreams come true for more than 10 years, and it started with nothing but a few hundred rand and a passion for design. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
Finally, we have you here. I have to tell you, you really are beautiful, talented, but you are South Africa's answer to Vera Wang.
I will take
your
that.
Your dresses are just so beautiful.
Thank you so much.
You make even me want to get married.
Thank you so much.
So you had a few hundred rand in your pocket.
Yes.
You kind of had a potential wedding dress, and you kind of had a bride, and that was it.
That was it. I had a job,
Talk about risks.
Yes, I had a steady job and I really didn't enjoy it.
Yeah.
So I sat my forks down and I said, listen, I really enjoy making pretty dresses and I want to go at it myself. That's going to mean that I need to live with you guys for at least another 5 years.
Yeah.
Are you okay with that? I think my mom jumped up and down with excitement. She's like, yeah, of course. And that's how it started.
And the reality of starting your own business is stressful. Did you have to live with your parents for 5 years?
Yes.
Or did you
I actually did live with them for 5 years and then moved out.
Yeah.
But it is stressful. And I mean, without that kind of support system, I don't think it would have... It would have happened the way that it did.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Well, thankfully it did.
Yes.
And it really, really took off. Now, your core business is, of course, bridal wear, but
you
do other kinds of, you know, formal evening wear, glitz, Oscar-ready gowns. But what goes into making a wedding gown? Because, I mean, this is quite a stressful work. You're making women's dreams come true. Let's have a look and see some of your perfection.
Yeah, well, what goes into it? I think it's a lot of hours, obviously, but for me, like I said, it's basically comes down to just making beautiful dresses, being creative. I actually just love seeing fabrics in the store and going, oh my word, I know exactly what I want to do with it, and making that happen.
And do you have the vision, or does a bride come to you and does she know exactly what she wants, or do they use you to kind of interpret how you see them?
It's both. It goes both ways. So what's really important for me with a wedding dress is that it should reflect the bride's personality with a custom-made dress. So I sit down with them for about an hour and we just chat what's important to them. What do they want to feel like? Do they have insecurities about their bodies that they want to maybe hide or not accentuate? And then we work together to create something.
Okay.
Because there's no point in me going, oh my word, I think this would look amazing on you, but the bride actually doesn't feel comfortable.
No, exactly. And the bride has to be comfortable.
Absolutely.
You do this incredible blog as well, where you give a lot of really helpful advice, actually, to potential brides. Tell me a little bit more about your
blog. So I think the biggest one on the blog was the stop doing the crash diets, but because for some reason, brides, and that's our biggest challenge, like brides feel they need to alter themselves in order to get married. They need to lose weight, they need to, I don't know, they've got these expectations.
False expectations about a bride.
My point is that the guy or your partner has already asked you to get married. He's pretty happy
he's
and stoked with you the way just that you are. So there's no need for all of that change. There's no need for the pressure. And for me, really, with these crash diets that we see, it essentially takes away everything that you need for your brain just to function normally, hormone levels to stay normal. And you mentioned stress just now. Not eating properly, that kind of thing. It just adds
It messes with
that.
You. It messes with every little bit of you.
Yes.
And actually, that'll make you gain weight instead of lose weight.
So
that's the stress.
Yeah.
Okay, your dresses are just magnificent. Have you ever had a bride not like her dress?
No, thankfully not. But that's also, for me, that's really important throughout the whole process. I tell them, like with any relationship, communication is key. So if you don't feel comfortable in something, if you feel like we need to maybe alter something, talk to me about it so that we can work on making you happy.
Where do a lot of women go wrong when choosing their wedding dresses? What should they really be cognizant of? Like the top things that they should, you know, ask you for when doing a dress?
They listen to other people and not to their own hearts.
Okay.
So for example, if the mom has has a certain vision of them looking like a princess. They sort of fall under the pressure and go, okay, fine, I want to make my mom happy, but actually they just want a plain minimalist style dress. And that's where we see a lot of people then either be unhappy or they want to get a different dress. Not that we've had that, but people have come to us and say, listen, I'm actually not happy with my dress. I want you guys to do it. So just, you need to keep, stay true to who you are as a person. Yeah.
Well, I have to tell you, I stalk you on Instagram all the time. And I mean, I'm not even close to getting married, but I just love looking at the dresses.
Thank you so much.
So talented. I mean, how exceptional are these dresses? Let us know what you think of them online. Pop us a little comment on our Instagram or Facebook or Twitter. And of course, we still have a really inspiring performance lined up by one of the most beautiful voices in South Africa. Pumeza Matshikiza is coming up after the break.
Looking for immune support? Remain at your peak all year round with Immuenza.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, I've been waiting for this all day. It's going to be so beautiful. Pumeza Matshikiza is in our loft today, and she is going to perform a classic by iconic Italian composer Giacomo Puccini. Bella ragazza.
Grazie.
Thank you.
Love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.